Hi guys, my name is Anna Maria and you're all very welcome to my channel. Today I will talk about cybersecurity, which seems to be a very popular and in-demand specialization. In this video, I want to dig deeper into cybersecurity and tell you why you should consider studying and working in cybersecurity. I'm sure you will find out some very unexpected things in this video, so make sure you watch it till the end. Computer security, cybersecurity, or information technology security protects companies, applications from theft and damage, from disrupting their normal services. And this is very important for companies to talk to specialists to find out different ways a company can be protected from these kind of attacks. Usually cybersecurity specialists, they do not do any programming, they just look for vulnerabilities in an app, for example, and they try to come up with recommendations on how programming can be fixed, changed, or improved in order to make sure that a company or an app is absolutely safe from any kind of potential attacks. Also, there are three main areas in cybersecurity. The first one is the technical one. So the technical side is when hackers try to hack an app, for example, and to find out if it's vulnerable, if it's easy to hack it. And in this situation, you might need a bit more programming skills, you might need a bit more skills to have, but it's absolutely fine because they can be learned. The second one is the non-technical side, is when a client comes to you and asks what potential risks his or her company can face. And as a non-technical specialist, you can advise the client of what he or she can do to make sure that his company is going to be safe and no one will be able to attack him. And this is what companies do because they have to make sure that the data which is held in their companies is not leaked or anything bad happens to them. And also there is another side, the third side to cybersecurity, and this is when specialists do respond to cyber incidents. So if something already happened, you will respond and help a client to come back to normal, to come back to his usual operations and services. Now let's talk about studying cybersecurity. You can find short courses, bachelor courses, master's courses in cybersecurity. Like for example, you can do bachelor, let's say in TU Dublin, and as a non-EU student, you'll pay 13,000 euro per year. It's a 4-year course. Or as an EU student, you'll pay about 5,000 euro per year. Also, there is no point in doing both bachelor and master's in cybersecurity. You can do just one of them and you will be absolutely fine working in this field. You can also do a course, you can get yourself a certification and you can start working in cybersecurity. So the unexpected thing is that you can get into this field very, very, very easy. As I mentioned, you can do different certificates in cybersecurity to start building up your career, and you can check in the description what kind of certificates you can take to be able to work in this field. Many companies also do provide training and help with these certifications, and it's worth checking during the interview, like asking if the company can provide some learning, which is amazing. And you see, it's actually very easy to get into this field. I did not expect it to be easy. I was always thinking that cybersecurity is something extremely complicated, extremely difficult. It's a very, very, very long process, but you can just get into the advisory field first of all, and then you can start building up your skills and get into the technical part if you want to. And this is so interesting because you always have to develop yourself, you always have to learn new things. In terms of job opportunities, so I checked online and I could find job opportunities mainly on LinkedIn. The salaries were not disclosed, so probably this will depend on your experience, on your skills, on how well you can negotiate with a company to give you a higher salary. So yeah, it would be worth checking those jobs on LinkedIn most likely. Now I want to talk about where you can get some more experience, some more knowledge. So first of all, online courses, college courses, and information on Google are the basic places where you can get more knowledge about cybersecurity. Also, there are plenty of useful websites websites that you can access and read, and you can check them in the description to this video because I left the links to those websites. And I'll be honest, at the beginning it's a bit difficult to read those news because there are plenty of new words and obviously you have to know those terms, but I found them pretty interesting, and if you are interested into doing cybersecurity, then those links will be very interesting for you. Also, there are two very good non-profit organizations, and they are called OWASP and ISACAM, and they can provide guidance for free. They organize different events, different talks, which are really worth attending because they will be very helpful and useful for you. So make sure you check those organizations on Google. You'll definitely have to follow them if you want to work in cybersecurity. These events are free to attend. You can also become a member of these organizations. And now the most important part is advice from specialists. And I really, really like advice from those people who already work in this field because they already know what to expect. They already have an idea of what's going to happen to you if you work in this field. So yeah, let me tell you what specialists told me. First of all, people who work in cybersecurity are really happy that they made the choice to work in this field as they find it something very, very interesting. Secondly, there are a lot of misconceptions of ways to get into cybersecurity because we always think that you need a bachelor's degree, even a master's degree, but this is not true. So again, as I mentioned, there is no point of doing both bachelor and master's in cybersecurity. Just pick up one and do one of them or just take some courses. You can also do bachelor in other fields, like for example, in business management, in marketing, in something else, but you need to have some transferable skills, like for example communication with clients. So you have to be able to have a business conversation with people. Also, you have to be able to write reports. Like for example, what I've learned during my business management course and at my work as a manager, I permanently have to write reports daily, weekly, and my whole life is built around reports, for example. And being able to write those reports is also very important, and problem solving again is a very important skill to have because many clients will come with very different problems and you'll have to do research and find out how to quickly and very effectively respond to their problems. Also, let's say that you studied to be a chef in college when you did your bachelor degree. You learned how to make nice cakes, tasty pancakes, and you decided to make a huge change in your life and become a cybersecurity specialist. And in this situation, you don't have to worry too much about your bachelor degree because you can just do master's in cybersecurity, or you can take a course in cybersecurity and you can start working in this field, which is very, very easy, and it's much easier than I did expect before. Cybersecurity specialists, they are constantly challenged at work because there is more and newer technology, and this means that there is more exposure to cyber attacks, and they have to constantly come up with new ideas. They have to constantly and daily do research about different kind of topics, about different kind of guidelines, rules, and this is very interesting because there is a lot of opportunity for growth and development, and you'll always have to learn new things. You'll just have to develop yourself. You'll always have to stay up to date with what's going on with the news in cybersecurity to be able to provide a high quality service to your client. Cool guys, so this is all the information that I found about cybersecurity, and I tried to structure it in such a manner that you can understand everything about it. And if you're a specialist in cybersecurity and you have something else to add, please write some comments because I might have missed something. And you know, I was so surprised that I only posted one story on Instagram and so many of you came back to me and told me so many things about cybersecurity. And I find it so, so, so interesting. And thanks a lot for all your help, for all your involvement. I'm really happy to have you all around me. Also, make sure you check all the links in the description to this video, especially if you want to develop yourself in this field. Make sure you give this video a like, you do subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next one.